Hi, this is Crafting Kurt, and today I'll be showing you how to make your own book cover to use in your Yourstory machine, just like this book that was the project on Platinum Scraps for this week. So first thing you need to do is figure out how many pages you want your book to have and how big you want your book to be. So I decided that I wanted my book to be 5x7, not including my spine. And I just used a sort of heavier chipboard and clipped all my edges going all the way around, and I needed two of those, one for the front and one for the back. Then for my spine, I used a much heavier chipboard. This is actually the back from a paper stack, the back chipboard piece, and it works really well for that. So here I have my spine pieces, and you need three of them. Now, to figure out how big I needed my spine pieces, I had to measure how big or how wide all of my pages would be when put together. So for example, if these post-it notes represented all of my pages that I wanted to put into my book, and I measure them and they're right at 3/4 of an inch, I cut my spine just a little bit bigger and I cut it to an inch so that when I put all of my pages in, I just have a little bit of space on either side, a little bit of wiggle room and breathing room for the glue to really grab hold to those pages. So once I'd done that, I cut three of them, and this is just a representation, not my actual book height. So you can then move on to creating your spine. And I just had the post-it notes here so it wouldn't stick to my table. Get rid of those. And here, I'm gonna create the spine. Now, you can get book binding tape, but one thing that really works and is really inexpensive is medical tape. And I like the slightly paper texture tape that's very, very similar to book binding tape. So first thing you want to do is place your first spine piece on the tape. So you're going to let this dry completely and then move on to the next step. So now that we have let our spine dry, we can move on to creating the outside cover of the book, the decorative part. And what you need to do is you need to do a little addition here. Here we are, and this is just for a book of a different size, but it really doesn't matter. The process is the same. So I started on one end, and I measured in an inch for my overhang. Then I measure from that overhang the width of my front. Then this is my 1/4 inch pinch, and you'll understand why that's important later on. And then this is one part of my spine, the middle of my spine, and the side of my spine. And like I said, once I got to that, I just used my spine and turned it over as I measured so that it was really accurate. From the edge of my spine, another 1/4 inch for my pinch, then my back cover, and then my other 1 inch overhang here. And you'll notice I put green dots all the way around because that's your overhang all the way around, and you really, really need that to have a very nice front for your book. You want it to look professional. Once you have this, you need to score all of your vertical lines, every single one, and at least one of, well, not at least one, you need to score only one of your horizontal lines. It doesn't matter which one, and those horizontal lines are just the height of your book, but just score one, and you'll understand why later. So pretending that this is my actual decorative paper that I would be using, I'm folding the overhangs in after my score. For the pinches, I'm folding both pinches back. Then, both lines on the pinch. Then I'm folding the spine inside, and once again, both pinches back. So here is my spine for the 5x7 book. And you'll notice that there's paper here that I covered the inside of the spine with cardstock. That isn't a necessary step, but I just like for it to look really finished on the inside, and just in case something doesn't quite line up correctly in the end, it still looks professional, and I just have a little bit of leeway. Now I can go ahead and line up my spine with the bottom once I peel the backing away, line it up, and moving one side at a time, apply the vinyl to the spine, add in my covers on each side one at a time. So I'm back and I've covered the outside in my vinyl. As I noted before, the vinyl today is just for demonstration purposes. I would definitely want to use a cardstock or a paper if I were really going to complete this project in my UDU, because the vinyl definitely has a potential to melt. Some won't, but some will, and it's just better not to even risk it. So once you get all of that done and you've applied glue to all your little areas that aren't touching the sticky back vinyl, now you can start your wrapping.
When you're standing on the side of a hill, feeling like it is maybe done, here it comes, the strawberry smoke, chasing away the sun. Don't let those precious moments fool you, happiness is getting you down. Rainbow never smiles or blinks, it's just a kind of colored frown. You were going on at 7:30, now it's going on 8:45. All the angels want to know, are you lost or treading?
So I'm back and I've completely covered my book. As I noted at the end of the previous little clip, yes, paste for when you do this actual project, when you're using paper, is what you need. And I just want to point out that I would use some type of putty knife to apply it, and a paintbrush for your edges, and really use that bone folder to get everything nice and smooth. Just because I'm demonstrating with vinyl, I didn't bring out the S-paste, but this is what you need to really get a nice smooth finish for your book, and it's a really great glue and holds everything down really securely. So I mentioned earlier that, not that one, I like this one, that I only scored one edge, and that's because once I lined everything up, I just used my bone folder to wrap over that other edge where it was, and it created, you see, a nice crisp edge, and I didn't have to worry about it being on the score mark. So just in case some things don't line up right and you need to tweak it a little bit, you have that opportunity to do so without having that extra score. So I'm just going to close the book now. And you remember that little pinch area that I talked about? Well, this is where it's going to come into play. I'm just going to really work that area and pinch it together so that, in essence, I'm creating the hinge area for my book. And you can use a number of things. You can use your hand to get in there. You can also use a ruler just to really, really impress that area and get it really pinched together. And you can just do that till you're satisfied with the results, till it pinches really easily. So now that the outside is done, we need to work on the inside. So here we are. My inside is glued down, and once again, I can't reiterate enough to take your time, use your yes paste, use a putty knife and a paintbrush for some of these smaller areas, and really, really let this dry completely, and take your time working all of these little creases. So you can move on to your pages, and in order to figure out how big you need your pages to be, you need to measure all the way into the spine, leaving about 1/4 inch to 1/2 inch from the edge. So this is about 6 3/8, so I would cut my pages to 6 and mark where my spine is so that I know I'm not doing anything that's going to be into the spine, any embellishment or any decoration, and also my pages aren't going to spill out of the edge. And you also want to do that for the height. So when you have all your pages done, whatever you want to do with them, we'll pretend that these are my pages for the book. And I like to use post-it notes to hold them together on 3 sides, not the side that's going to go into the spine, but the other 3. Just because when the glue melts, the pages tend to settle a little bit and shift. And, you know, even when you're using one of the pre-made book covers for the Yourstory machine, it still happens. So this is a method that I came up with that tends to really work well. Moving on to glue. For the glue, you can either use a prefabricated heat bond glue strip, thermal glue strip, and I'm putting up the website on this video where you can find those. They work very, very well. They're great. Or you can try something that is really easy and works just as well and a lot less expensive. Hot glue. Normal, regular hot glue works really well if you can find one of the really strong high bond hot glues that are out there. That would be even better. But you just want to cover the bottom, leaving about a quarter to a half of an inch on either side, being sure that you cover the length of your page, but not so much that your glue is going to be spilling out onto your heating plate in your U-do and have a big mess. So anyway, fill this area with hot glue, and you want it to be about an eighth of an inch thick, an eighth of an inch to a quarter of an inch thick. Let that hot glue dry completely till it's hard again. And then you just place your pages, we'll pretend, inside your book. Place all of that inside your Yourstory machine once it is heated up and is ready to go. And you will end up with a wonderful little book that you created that is very personal and is just a really great craft. I hope you guys enjoyed my very brief rundown of how this project was done. If you need any more instructions, please don't hesitate to contact me at craftandkurt.blogspot.com. Go there, leave me a comment where this project is posted, and I will help you in any way I can. Thanks a lot, and as always, we have another dance break.